A long time ago, at the dawn of pole fishing, Shimano ruled the roost. Their AX and AZ models were what every match angler clamoured for. And back then, we didn't need names, letters and numbers, done it. Moving forward, Shimano had Katana, Power Loop, Hyperloop, the Stradic, the Exarge, and then they upped the game a little bit with the Beastmaster. And the Beastmaster with the yellow handle, the margin pole, became one of the best-selling poles on the market. After that, we had Fireblood and the beautiful Aspire. After that, nothing. The end. Until now, that is. Because after a 10-year gap, a decade away from the pole market, Shimano are back. After 4 years of solid research, development, sampling, more sampling, they have finally settled on a new three-pole range called the Aero. And today, I think I'm one of the first people that are going to get to fish with one of them. You're seeing this pole exactly as I'm seeing it. This is straight out the bag. Yes, I've seen it at the Big One show, as maybe some of you did. And yes, I've had a word with Nick Speed about it because he has had an awful lot to do with its development. And he said his 4 years of sweat, blood and tears have gone into this. And with a huge amount of sampling and resampling. And the truth about that is there are very few firms, and maybe only two, that can afford to do that sort of development. So this is technically one of the most advanced poles I've seen across. In fact, so many bits of this pole got going on for it that I've had to make notes that I'll be reading from. Now let's get the little painful bit out of the way. Price rise, there's three in the range, the Aero X5, the Aero X7, and the top of the range Pro Competition. I haven't got here because it's early days and I think you can get hold of the poles by July, but it's early days for them and Nick's got the only one I know about at the moment. But price-wise, the X5 is going to set you back $1,699. This one, which is the mid-range pole, $2,999. And the top of the range Pro Competition, £4,999. So price-wise, they're in there with most of the poles on the market. But technical specifications-wise, boom. As I took the pole out of its tube, I was absolutely, in fact, I nearly dropped one. The finish on the pole, which is called an ultrasound sanding system, is unlike anything I've felt before. It runs the entire length of the pole, and all three poles, by the way, are 16 meters long. They are also all guaranteed to be the same or stated length. So if you're lucky enough to get picked for England or you're going into Europe and have to fish by Sips and Fips rules, you will have a pole at the right length without having to cut bits off of it. It's got what you expect in as much as it's got a joint alignment system, but the section joints are just unbelievable. And I've sat and played with them. The female joint, which is this side of the pole, has a 1K cross weave on it, which they use is, you know, that the cross weave gives it incredible strength. There's no ovaling there at all. But the male joint has a cross diamond finish on it. And that cross weave finish prevents a pole from getting stuck together even when it's wet, but makes it come apart easily. And I've had a go at joint banging them in and it's not going to stick, but every joint just comes apart with a lovely swooshing sound. So that's new development. The mandrel itself is the same mandrel for all three poles and it's done with advanced tapering. And what Shimano would mean by that is I'm looking down, especially this is like the fourth section, and it looks a little bit wider in diameter than I've seen for a while. But when you design poles, if you're starting from scratch, like Shimano have done with this pole, and like Nick Speed said to me, 4 years of blood, sweat, and tears into this, you can change the mandrel sizes, lengths, and the diameters to give you a stiffer pole. And this is an advanced taper mandrel that's used for this pole, one that hasn't been seen before. And having had, I'm not a fish, but having just picked it up, My word. Nick Speed said to me, when you pick it up, Mark, have a look at it, but then put the short three. You get a couple of short threes with the Essex 7 model with it, and you put the short three in, he said, and it is ridiculous. I agree with him. It is. But moving up the pole to the top kits, so you get two types of top kits with it. You can get Pro Match and a Pro Power. They've got depth markers on, as you would understand. The alignment system runs up to the second section here as well. They are PTFE'd, which is really handy, and they are reinforced, even more reinforced in here, and they are reinforced for a side puller kit should you wish to put one in, which I would. And I think I've been over side puller kits, in my opinion, of poles without them enough to not make a big deal of that. But, you know, you're going to have your side puller kits put in. So it's been, I think the carp are a little bit more interested in themselves than they are what I'm doing, but we've resorted to a bit of slapping, and I've just caught what would be my first fish on this pole. As for fishing with it, slapping, I put the short, you know, Speedy said to me, like, put the short three in it, Mark. It's incredibly stiff, and it is. It really is. I've had a go with the joints as well. Perfect. I can't fault them. Shimano say that this one, the X7, is the all-rounder of the range, and I would say that, you know, with the match kits in, it's very light. I mean, I know the guy, I'm here at Bishop's Bowl, and Sean Smart, that owns the place, he's come and had a look. Famous for breaking fishing stuff, Sean Smart, by the way. He's come and had a look at it, and with the match kit in, he said that's very impressive. And he's seen a lot of fishing stuff, so I take that as a good sign. It's always difficult with a new pole because you're not sure how it's gonna, in fact, that fish is absolutely going potty there. You're not sure how it's gonna perform. And I'm taking it a little bit gingerly. But the ultrasound sanding sound finish is absolutely unbelievable. That really is. In fact, when I get this fish out, I'm gonna show you a couple of things that I've had a look at that we'll talk a bit further about. Power wise, I mean, yeah, it seems pretty strong, and this is not a small fish on here. I'm not, let's say, your confidence is never that great with a new pole, because it's, especially when it's not your own and you're not too sure how it's going to be. But I have to say, it's not filling me full of fear. Although this fish is not, it's not a very happy fish, that's a fact. And I think it's going to be interesting trying to get it in between these reeds. But it's a good, you know, first fish up with a pole, it's a pretty good test for it. You always think, please don't, please don't break. But I don't, you know, you've got to get your confidence with it. But no, it's, you just know. I know Nick Speed, and there's no way he's going to have ever put a pole out that he hasn't been happy with. So you just know it's going to be strong. And the places he fishes and the amount of fishes that he catches are impressive. And so is the pole. So we like that. That's a fish playing bit over. But like I said, let me share a couple of things that I've dared to do with this pole that I think, and it's to do with the joints, it's very impressive. Let's pop him back and I'll show you what I'm talking about. When it rains and it's warm and you're undoing your pole a lot and shipping it about and shipping it back up, one of the worst things you can do is once your joints get wet and you've got to put it together, right? It's fatal. And I've never done this with a pole before because, and Sean stood there watching me and said, that's not a clever thing to do, Mark. But so we'll soak that. In it goes. I've locked it. And if you give it a minute for the suction to work, you'll think, he's not getting that undone. He's not done a clever thing there. Really? Oh my life. That's impressive. What are you saying? Whilst I was messing about with the water, and if you're sat there thinking he didn't push them sections together, trust me, there's people here watching me, I'm not going to get away without pushing those sections together. I really pushed it together and it really came apart like that. Anyway, I thought, while I'm at it, I'll wet my hands and see how it ships, because I've really liked this finish since I've picked the pole up. It's unlike anything I've really felt before on a pole finish. So watch this. It couldn't be any wetter. And the only noise you can hear is the pole going through my hands. And that is shipping with wet hands ridiculously easy. Let's get a couple of bits on the roller and I'll show you. Every section, every female section has a reinforced banding. So not only do you get the cross wrap, the 1K carbon extra cross wrap on it, you've got this banding. And what that does is it makes it super tough. So you're not going to probably chip it and you're not going to damage it like that. You certainly can't flatten it out or oval it. And even if you're thinking you're fishing short, and that can be really iffy when you're fishing a short line, because you've a tendency, especially when the poles are as stiff as this, to get a bit overzealous. It would maybe just protect it a little bit from cracking, although I would probably try and put a skid bug or something in there. But the technical standard of this pole really is quite something. And yes, I mean, it does cost a lot of money. It's a £3,000 pole, but I haven't got the pro competition, but I can only imagine just how good that pole would be. Nick, there's just one question I have to ask you though, right? How quickly can we meet up so I can get my hands on the pro competition?
Well, by the sounds of it, as soon as possible, mate. You'll absolutely love it. It's simply awesome. So we'll definitely put a pencil in the date for that.
All right, mate. I'll speak to you soon. Really soon.
All right.
Cheers, mate. Bye. Bye.